We'll complete the stairway in the module file first, and then check how these changes are reflected in the host file. Save the current file. Select File, Open from the menu. Browse for the previously saved staircase module file. You may enable Module File in the Open File dialog to list only module files. Select the staircase module and click Open. Ignore the warning message about the missing library element if it appears, and also close the library loading report to proceed. The module file opens. Let's fit the contents into the floor plan window. We'll add some windows first. Activate the Window tool in the toolbox and open the Window Settings dialog. Select the Storefront window from the Storefronts folder. On the Preview and Positioning page, enter 1500 mm for width, 2600 mm for height. Make sure that Sill to Story 1 is selected, and enter 100 mm for its value. Select Reveal to Wall Face, and enter 0 for its value. Set the anchor point to Side 1. Open the Parameters panel, and unfold the Surfaces container. Select Glass Blue Dark for glass surface. Display the Storefront Settings panel of the dialog. Check out all the various pages and options available here. Please do not modify anything at this time. Click OK to close the dialog. We will insert a new window at a distance of 300 mm from the vertical concrete walls. Zoom in to the upper part of the vertical concrete wall on the left. Move the cursor to the left edge of the wall and wait for the orange dot to appear. Click on the dot to activate a guideline. Move the cursor to the intersection point of the guideline and the horizontal wall as shown on the screen. Type X and 300 minus. The cursor moves 300 mm to the left. Click Enter to place the window. Move the cursor up and to the right to define the opening direction. Place a window in the opposite side of the same wall as shown on the screen. Insert two additional windows in the vertical wall on the right side as well. Zoom in to the upper part of the vertical wall on the right. Create a guideline. Select the Side 2 anchor point in the info box. And place a new window 300 mm to the right. Place another window at the bottom of this wall, as shown on the screen. Zoom out to investigate the results. Open the Window Settings dialog box and display the Preview and Positioning page. Enter 2,860 mm for width. Set the anchor point to center. Display the Storefront Settings page of the dialog. Select panels from the list. Enter 2 for horizontal division number. Click OK to close the dialog. Zoom in to the bottom horizontal wall. Find the center of this wall with the help of the smart cursor. Click this point to insert a new window as shown on the screen. Zoom out. Check the result in 3D. As the final step, we'll place a window in the stairwell. Let's go back to the floor plan. Open the Window Settings dialog box and display the Preview and Positioning page. Enter 2600 mm for width, so it's equal to the width of the stairs. Make sure that the height is also 2600 mm. Modify the anchor point to side 2. Click OK to proceed. We are going to place the window flush with the right side of the left vertical wall. Zoom into the upper part of the vertical wall on the left. Create a guideline segment. Move the cursor over the right side of the wall segment and click on the guideline handle represented by an orange dot. This is how we find the intersection point of the vertical and the horizontal walls. Insert the window as shown. Activate the Save command from the File menu to save the module.